சம்பந்தேஜகத்குரும். Just now we recited a verse from the Bhagavad Gita. யோந்தஸ் சுக அந்தராராம. Two words, அந்தஸ் சுக. These words are very familiar with all our spoken languages. Internal bliss, that is the meaning of antas sukha. Antaranama, arama means garden. We develop a beautiful, eco-friendly garden inside. Such people will be very happy, ever contented, ever blissful, ever enthusiastic, ever active. That is what we aim at in our life journey. This time, in our international conference, we are projecting a mantra. Master key verse. This verse, we call it Swasthya Saptakam. Seven verses giving a message of health. That is how we gave the name to this song, which we are chanting every day before the sessions are started every day. Swasthya means health. Saptaka means seven verses for good health. How it is got? Chikitsa yogata. Treatment only by yoga, which has no side effects. This is experimented. This university is meant for that goal, that aim. Already now, world is ready to take this mantra. Yoga is the only real remedy for all type of ailments. Our band of workers are taking that mantra to every nook and corner of the whole nation and the globe as such. Next one. So with proper understanding, every day you can sing this song. Now this song is in everyone's mouth. That always ringing, all are very happy with this song. One part is that is vocal part with a specially designed tone and tune that is making us very happy. That is one point. Another one is the meaning part of the shloka. With proper understanding, if we sing, it will be still more meaningful. Main problem is negativity at mental level. That is the problem. As we are advancing, as we are marching ahead with science and technology, its side effect is very much seen at psychological level, that our psyche is full of negativity, which leads to so much various types of illness at physic and psych. So nishedhatmaka chinta, negative thoughts, it takes us to doomsday. That is the meaning of that one. Chitaroha sunishchita. As we develop more and more negativity, our own doomsday becomes very nearer. That is why we have to avoid all this negativity. Power of positive thinking we have to develop. For that, yoga is the only panacea. That is why yoga tantra swasthya siddhihi. yoga tantra, that yogic technique, that is what facilitates good health. And this is the mantra for modern man. And this is the wealth. Yoga is the real wealth for our health. Our university, S. Vyasa University, Sri Vivekananda Yoga Anusandhana Samsthana University, is ready to contribute it to the whole society as such with all its researches. So many research articles published in many international journals. That is how every subsequent day we are enriching yoga with proper research and insight and sadhana. One is research, another one is sadhana. Both must go hand in hand. Mere research many are doing, but it becomes too academic sometimes without sadhana. There are many, many such organizations, they go for sadhana. Every day they go for asana, pranayama, yama, niyama. That much sadhana they do. That is the real core part of yoga, but it must be supported by modern science and technology. That is why we must go for research activities also. These two are combined. On one side sadhana, yoga jivana, our whole life is cemented, totally integrated with yoga, that is one part. Another part, it is academic excellence and yogic research insight. These are very important. Swastyam, health. Shiksha, education. Shama, tranquility. Shantihi, mental equality, equilibrium. This is what will protect the whole sea of humanity. If we just go for technology, we are just undergoing all type of havocs created now. That is why now when we march ahead in this century, 21st century, and we go for 22nd, 23rd like that, the main mantra becomes this: Swasthya, Shiksha, Samaha, Shanti. Four pronged activities: health, education, tranquility, equilibrium, balance of mind. Without this, any science and technology good, it will never give ultimate solace to mankind. We have to realize. Earlier the better, we have to realize. So Vivekananda gave this message. We are celebrating 150 years now in this year. So in this particular high time, we have to realize, and with Vivekananda Yoga, we have to march ahead and make this wonderful world, beautiful world, full of calmness, full of tranquility, full of understanding, full of sharing and caring. These are the main things for sustenance of mankind under the sun on this earth. That is why we must go every day for yogasana, because the sun god is so compassionate to give health to us. When we go for health, we must have regular practice of Surya Namaskar every day in the morning. While the sun is rising on that horizon of the eastern section of the sky, we must be ready with Surya Namaskara, with 13 mantras. Mitra vi surya bhanu khaga kusha hiranyagar bhavani chahitya savitrak bhaskare bhyo nama. That is how we have to start our life journey every day. So bhaskara, from the sun god, arogya michet, man must go for health. That wealth of health, it is given by the sun god. You know, this now trend is so healthy now. As I know, in many countries, young people, they are taking up the Surya Upasana mission. Eco-friendly life system, those go for, they go to Surya Namaskar. Now in many Western countries, they don't burn gas because it disturbs eco balance. That is how they have developed many, many organizations, eco-friendly organizations. In Finland, Denmark, in so many such as Norway, in those countries. There, the followers of this sadhana, members of this organization, they always go for worship of sun god. That is their mode of worship. And same, on the side, they don't burn the gas. That will be another bhaktiya, discipline of their life. That is how, on the other side, so much positive development taking place. Young people going for eco-friendly life, going for Surya Namaskara, going for worshipping the sun god. Yogam Ichchet Janardhanat. Sri Krishna, he gives yoga. That is what every morning we are getting, that Krishna yoga. Krishna gave this yoga mantra. When that our society was in so much a dilemma, in so much depression, Krishna gave this yoga. You know, a person one who receives this message from Narayana, Sri Krishna, Partha, Arjuna, he was very much victim of these depressions, disgust, disappointment and all these series of these. Such a Nara, Arjuna, he was lifted to that level. Nashto Mohan, Smritir Labdha, Tot Prasada, O Krishna, by your prasada, your grace, your blessing, I regained all these. I could discard my ignorance. I could wipe out my passion so that I could regain my internal capacity. Now with your message, I march ahead. That is what promise he gives. We are all like that. We are all company. In the company of Partha. Partha and co-company we belong to. Here Krishna's yoga becomes wonderful, full stuff for our life journey. Ishana Tyagami Chet Shiva, an embodiment of Tyaga, sacrifice. You know how much the real yoga it is synchronized, epitomized in the form of Shiva. He is the real yogi. That is why sitting on the mountains range, he will be doing always tapasya. That is the greatness of Lord Shiva. So that Ishana means Lord Shiva's incarnation. Shiva got five main incarnations. Sadyojata, he will be like child. Vamadeva, he will be like great sage. Sadyojata, Vamadeva. Aghora, the third face of Shiva, he will be very much aggressive, destroying all demons, all rajas symptoms. That is called Aghora, Aghora incarnation of Shiva. Sanjivajata, Amadeva, Aghora, Tatpurusha. He embodies that consciousness. Tatpurusha, Adhyatma Vidya. Then the Ishana, Iti Ishana Sarva Vidyanam, Ishvara Sarva Bhutanam, Brahmadhipati. He will be just like small, innocent boy, preaching Vedanta Shastra, the Upanishads to all Sanaka Sanandana Sanat Kumara Sanat Sujata. That form, that incarnation of Shiva is called, Ishana. So Ishana, very much pure at his sight, very pure, embodiment of sincerity and purity. That type of incarnation of Shiva is called Ishana. So Ishana, he gives us a tyaga, a sense of austerity, sense of renunciation. Those who do all these things, so take inspiration from all these divine personalities, like the sun god, like Sri Krishna Paramatma, and Shiva, great Shiva, they will be free from mental and physical illnesses. Raga, roga vivarjita. Raga is mental imbalance, psychological problem. Roga, it is physical. These three are haunting goats. Haunting goats. now in this modern world, that is to be wiped out.
Then it is
Vivekananda Yogindram Natva Vyasamneeshwaram, this shloka. This year we are here to remember again and again that great personality, heroic personality, Vivekananda. Where both Viveka and Vijnanamaya Kosha, that Viveka means Ananda is Anandamaya Kosha. These two are combined in his personality. That type of personality we are remembering and drawing inspiration from him and marching ahead. In the same time, Vyasa, that very name, it is embedded in the preamble of this university. Vyasa, he embodies three or Trimurti. Achaturvadano Brahma, Dvivahur Aparo Harihi, Aphalalochana Shambhu, Bhagavan Badarayana. That is how this stotra tells about Vyasa, great Rishi, who lived here when this whole society was under the clutches of Arthagama. All those were, they were just behind lust and desire, anger, and all these were the haunting problems. He brought dharma and moksha, righteousness and liberation. That is how he could revolutionize the whole society. That type of great sage is called Vyasa. Anybody, any great rishi comes with this message, descends to the earth, makes this whole society ascended upward. That type of great personality is called rishi in this land. He is the real successor of that tradition, rishi tradition. That Vyasa we remember and we march ahead. Ultimately, our main thrust is now removing this menace. SDM. Diabetes program. Diabetes removing. Stop diabetes moment. That is the real mantra. We are giving this to the whole society. It is only due to imbalance at our psychological level and at our life system. Life system, it is very much imbalanced. Early in the morning we don't get up. We don't take eco-friendly life, eco-friendly food. Our standing, our walking, our talking, our eating, our sleeping, every activity is anti-eco balance. That is why by our own behavior, by our own attitudes, we are welcoming this Madhumeha diabetes. At this root level, if we make something, correction, proper reformation, corrections and the thing bring in, naturally you will be free from all these diseases. Just we go for temporary yoga, half an hour yoga, 20 minutes yoga. No, no. It is life yoga, jivana yoga. Whatever we do, it must start with getting up early in the morning. That must be the first lesson of yoga. Get up early in the morning, take up that wonderful sun god's grace, positive rays, ozone, enjoy. With that you start your life, you will be free from all this illness. Then go for some asana pranayama, go for some meditation. So, before the sunrise, whatever time we use for yoga, that makes us free from all diseases. This we have to understand. So, we must go for eco-friendly life. That is called yoga life. So that now India, which is considered as the guru for Adhyatma, now this India becoming hub of diabetes. What is this? So people, now all our doctors, scientists, they are giving warning. Now we have to understand. What we are giving to this modern world? What does this India give to the whole world? India must give knowledge. India must give health. That is our wealth. That we have to share. That is why Bharata Desha Vasi Janata. Where, from where this light must shed, there only with this so much thick darkness. What to do? That is why this chamber from which this light must spread everywhere, every nook and corner, there must be proper lighting. There we have to lit light. There we have to bring that proper illumination. From that, it must go to every part. Nana Sankhetanam. So that these aims and objectives, many organizations are working, they all come together with that motto, mission. This time we are organizing this international organization. That is also embedded in this line. Bhanana Sankhatanasya Moolamadhuna Sakhyam Param Prepsitam. All NGOs, government agencies and other like-minded sisterly organizations, they are all coming. You all coming, you have come here and you are participating and taking this message to your own place. That is how Stop Diabetes Movement will be a boon to the whole society, for whole sea of humanity. With that motto, we are organizing this international conference. It is so happy that most of you are very good seekers, all are sadhakas, Junayan sadhakas. Your concern is so highly applauded. Work. So that is what it is structured in this seven shloka, samuchaya, group of seven shlokas. That is the essence of this Swasthya Saptaka. With this understanding, let us sing and let us bring it, take it to our own places and let us popularize this Saptaka, shloka Saptaka, every day morning as soon as you get up. Sing these seven shlokas with proper understanding, so that the whole day will be very much filled with positive note, awareness, health awareness. So that is how we can make it. We can make it regular chanting, part of our regular chanting early in the morning as soon as we get up. So that let us carry this Swasthya Saptaka shloka with its mission, with its meaning. Om Tat Sat.